Named Chris tweets screen grabs at Denver police, alerting them to a Facebook profile spewing hate and violence. The Facebook user refers to himself as a genocide machine, asking for help raiding a police station.
Whatever they sent to us, we can try to use that in the investigation, but we always want them to start contacting the communication center first.
Police responded to the tweet saying they cannot process tips on Twitter and encouraged the man to call them. DPD tells the problem solvers people will report a variety of things to its official Twitter account, but the account is not monitored 24/7. They say something that needs immediate attention requires a call or text to 911.
Stuff that should go through our communication center, because when it goes through there, an officer will be able to respond and take care of what needs to be taken care of.
But the way society communicates is always evolving, especially in the age of social media.
People think of social media much like they think of a phone.
Lynn Schofield-Clark chairs the University of Denver's Department of Media, Film, and Journalism Studies.
They see Twitter as something that is an avenue for being in touch with police or teachers or with anybody else who's in the public life. And that is a concern because I think it means that those of us who are in public positions have a responsibility to monitor what's happening in social media to a much greater extent than we do right now.
And that begs the question, will social media use of the future change police procedure? Could we one day see police expand their social media teams and use sites like Twitter and Facebook as additional avenues into dispatch centers? For now, though, texting and calling 911 are still the best ways to get the fastest police response.